Welcome back to the 8th part of the series How to Create Dozens of City Prompts in Blender 2.82. In this tutorial, we are going to model and bench and then texture it in Substance Painter. So, hands on, and I hope you enjoy the video. So, let's start with the modeling. I'm going to add some curves. So, let's start. I will press 3 on the numpad to go to right orthographic, Shift and A. Add some bezier curve. I will rotate here on the y axis, so R, Y, and 90 degrees. And from this, let's start editing it. So I'm just pressing Tab to go to edit and grab the center of this line, G to move, and start moving and rotating this to create the base shape of the bench metal. So I will press S to scale here and R to rotate also, and this one I'm going to grab the center, move it around here, E to extrude, left click to apply, R to rotate, and rotate somewhere here. So this will be the side of the bench. I think looks enough. So let's go here to object data properties. Since this is not a mesh, we can edit the bezier curve. So I will increase the resolution here by multiplying let's say by 2, and expand here the geometry tab. I will give an extrude of around 0.2, and also increase a bit the depth. So 0.05 looks okay to me. And also I think it's too thick. So let's go back. So 0.15 or 0.1. Yes, this looks perfect. So press 3 again to go to right orthographic, Tab to go to edit mode, and from here we can now just select the center of a vertex here, Shift and D to duplicate, and once we apply it where we want to start. So I will let's say somewhere here will be the bench. So I will apply by left mouse click, E to extrude, and as you can see, all the properties that we changed are also applied. So let's leave it somewhere here and start rotating. Or we can do it the opposite direction. So I will select this new one, press R, and on the Z axis by 180 degrees, and we can play a little bit with it just to have a smooth bench. I will like this one. So Shift and D again to create the front length, E to extrude, R to rotate, let's play a bit more with this one, and also rotate, scale to increase the curve. So on G on the Y axis, and I think that's pretty nice. Shift D again, this time around here, E to extrude, and I would like to rotate and create something more complex to this bench, just to add some more detail to it. So G to move, g to move and also increase the curve of this one. G, I want to move a bit the length back and also apply this one, and I will just make it a bit smaller. So grab this one, move it around here, let's say R to rotate, G, and I think this is a nice start. And we can also apply fill caps, and now we are ready to make it as a mesh. So object, convert to, and mesh from a curve. So this is now a mesh and not a bezier anymore. So now let's add a modifier to increase our speed, but first let's apply all the transforms. So Control and A, all transforms applied. Add the array modifier and increase here the offset to the X axis. This is a nice bench here, so I will apply also this. Now if we press tab to go to edit, select everything, shift and S, cursor to select it in order to send the cursor in the exact middle of these two objects. So shift and A to start adding the wood. So mesh, create a cube, one on the numpad or control one, scale on the Z axis, something like this, 7 to contour view, scale on the Y around here, let's see how it looks. I prefer it a bit more to the Y axis, and now 7 and scale on the X axis here. And let's also add the bolts and apply them to the wood. So G and Z to bring it a bit to the Z axis, 7 to go top view, shift and A, and add a UV sphere. So I will go back to 3, so right orthographic, edit the sphere, Z and wireframe, B for box selection, select until here, X and delete all vertices. So this is a nice bolt. So going back to solid and tap for object mode and scale it until it will be something really small. G on the Z. Let's press 7. G on the X axis, and I think it's okay. So shift and D on the X to the other side, 7 to go on top view, dot to zoom in, G on the X, and just drag it at the middle. So I would like to join all these, so Control and J, select everything, Shift and S, cursor to the selected in order to send the cursor to the middle, and set origin by right click, set origin to the 3D cursor. So now we can start adding this. So I will press G to start from here, scale on the Z We can scale it a bit more and rotate and just move it close to the metal. So Shift and D, rotate, and just create a gap between them. So Shift and D, rotate, and here I will speed up the process until I am done with it. So this is what we created. I think it seems really nice. So time to add the materials and then go to Substance Painter in order to texture it. So this will, I will create a new material. It will be the black metal. And I will also set the base color to a black one. Let's change also the preview to the material preview. And for this wood here, excuse me, I will create a new material, which be the wood. And also change the color to a wooden one. And let's select all of them. And if we press Ctrl L, we can link the material. Select everything except the first one, so this will be the last. Select it as the last, Ctrl L, and link material. So everything now has the exact same material. And also for these bolts here, I will select just pressing Shift, selecting a vertex, and press L in order to select the whole linked vertices. So I'm creating a new material here, which be the bolt. I will give a gray color for the bolts and assign. So let's repeat for the bolts. I will also speed a bit the process here. So this is our bench. We can now select everything, press Ctrl and J to join them all together once we apply the modifiers. So Ctrl and J to join everything. And that's our bench. So now let's move on to the UV editing. We have to select everything and press U and Smart UV Unwrap. This has to be done in order to proceed to a Substance Painter. So this is our UVs already, and time to move on. So as I told you in the previous video that we textured for the first time in Substance Painter, in order to add your model in Substance Painter and start texturing, you have to export it as FBX. I will not go through all these steps again, but you can see at the top right corner of your screen now the previous video, and continue after that. So first of all, we have to press File and New, select our FBX model. So I click to open and OK. First thing that we do, as I mentioned in the last video, we have to bake all the textures. So in texture set settings, here is the option for additional maps. So we pressing bake textures. Here I will uncheck the normal one and bake textures. So once everything is done, we are changing back to the shelf and going to the smart materials. Here, as you can see, to the texture set list, it's the materials that we created in Blender. So this is why we are creating different materials for each thing that we will like and naming in order to know what we are texturing to. So I will first check the black metal, and I will search here in smart materials for a metal one. I would like this black scratched metal, so I'm just dragging here to the layers, and it will automatically be applied to the bench. So moving on to the wood, I will search here for a wood. I would like this light wood material, so I'm just dragging here. Material applied, and moving also to the bolt. So searching again for a metal one, but this time to a steel, to engrave steel. So I will drag this one here, and as you can see, the bench is already textured with some nice details to it. After we are done with our texturing, we can export our textures in order to import them back to in Blender and render our bench. So we are going to File, Export Textures, and locate where you like to store them and export all of them. After the export is finished, we are going to move back to Blender and import the textures. So switching back to Blender in order to apply the textures, let's change to shading and also here to render view. Just to mention here, I have already an HDRI opened, and from here we can search for our textures where you exported from Substance Painter. So for the black metal, we have here the base color, connect to the base color. The heat map, where we can connect it with a math node, connect the color to the first value and the output value to the displacement. This is the metallic, so color to the metallic of the principal PSDF, and the normal map, where we can connect it by embump. So I'm searching here for embump, color to the height, and the normal to the normal of the principal PSDF. And finally, we have the roughness for the metal. So let's zoom a bit more. I will move this. I will not close all of them because I'm going to use them again for the rest of the material. So roughness to the roughness of the principal PSDF. And now for the wood, we are going to select everything from the black metal. So A to select everything, Control C to copy. We are going to the wood one, A to select everything here, X to delete, and Control and V to paste. Now I will not drag and drop from here, but instead I will just open and select the base for the wood, the metallic for the wood, so wood metallic, the roughness here for the wood, so wood roughness, the normal map, and the heat map. And last, for the bolt, so selecting everything, X to delete, Control V to paste, and open the base color for the bolt, metallic, roughness, normal, and the height. So let's change to layout view and render view. As you can see, everything, all the textures are applied. I will change here to a different HDRI because this one, as you can see, has a lot of green reflection to the bench. So I'm changing to something more smooth. And once it's applied, we are going to press Shift and A and add a camera. So 0. I will zoom in a bit, and for properties here, a view, and lock the camera to the view, the 3D view, and we can move it around, change to cycles, GPU, and I would like to render to 200 samples. So this is all the steps needed in order to model texture and bring the textures back to Blender in order to render for a bench. I hope everyone enjoyed this video, and if you liked it, press the like button, leave a comment to the description below, and of course don't forget to subscribe.